It's Ryan here from Aquent Recruitment. Now I'm back here today with another episode of Ask Aquent, where I'm going to be doing a deep dive on my top tips to make your resume not suck. So without further ado, here are my top tips. So my first tip is arguably the most important tip and the simplest tip as well, and that is keep your resume short and sweet. A resume should be between 1 to 2 pages in length maximum. I don't care if you've had 1 year experience or if you've had 50 years of experience, your resume needs to be short and straight to the point. You want to be talking about the most important things that you've done with each of your roles. It should be an appetizer, not a full buffet. It should be an appetizer and give the reader enough information about the types of things that you've been doing in your previous roles. Now, there's been a lot of research into how long recruiters and hiring managers actually spend reading your resume. And the answer is a little surprising. On average, recruiters spend anywhere between 6 to 10 seconds reading a resume. It's not long. So you want to give them as much information as you can in as short amount of time as possible. And the best way to do that is to keep your resume short and sweet. So the next tip that I actually give a lot of my candidates is include tangible results in your resume. So if you've worked on a program of work, or if you've developed a new marketing campaign, or you've rebranded something, you want to be able to showcase the actual tangible results that you've actually been able to deliver while you're in that position. So maybe you were actually able to increase revenue, or maybe you were able to actually get a range of new leads into the business. Those types of tangible results are what hiring managers and recruiters are looking for when they're reading the resume. They want to see that you've actually been able to perform in a role previously and deliver tangible results back to the business. Use keywords in your resume. So when people like recruiters or hiring managers are actually reviewing your resume, what they're going to be looking for is particular keywords or particular areas of experience. So be sure to have a look at what the actual job description is asking for. Is it asking for people with email marketing experience? Is it asking for people with experience with paid social? And if it is, be sure to include that information actually in your resume. Because when they're scanning through your resume, looking for those keywords to see what you've been doing, that's going to entice them enough to actually then go, okay, this person knows what they're talking about. They've done the exact things that I'm looking for. I'm going to pick up the phone and give them a call and see if they want to do an interview. And really, at the end of the day, that's what your resume is there to do. It's to just get people interested enough to pick up the phone and book an interview with you. My last piece of advice is don't BS on your resume. Any recruiter or hiring manager worth their weight is going to be actually able to spot BS pretty darn quickly when they're reading through your resume. There's a big difference between painting yourself in the best possible light and just straight up lying on your resume. So at the end of the day, be honest, be transparent about what your experience has been, and you'll be absolutely fine. Just don't BS, or you're gonna be wasting your time, and you're gonna be wasting the other person's time as well. Thank you so much again, guys, for joining me for another episode of Ask Aquent. I'm glad you could join us. I hope you got some value out of that. If you're interested in talking to me about different roles and how I can help you find your next position, please feel free to reach out. Feel free to send me an email, slide in the LinkedIn DMs, or if you're old school, feel free to just give me a phone call. I'll include the information below. But yeah, thank you so much again. We'll chat soon.